anyone watching thinking we know fuck all about knowing fuck all about needs to watch their back. So you've had your Labour reclassifying scum, sending prices sky high, literally taking the grass from its own roots. Now you've got your condemnation. Liberals noshing Tories like altar boys picking dimps up. Have we had a national fucking stroke? Or what? Is revolution a word? Or was it never? Anybody watching needs to know we cope better than average with irony in Chatsworth. Well, for fuck's sake, we live in Manchester and they charge us for water. I wandered lonely as a clown, necking mushrooms rarely found. It's green and pleasant land and ancient time. It's not theirs anymore. This is our England now.
Depressing thought number 261. You can never truly know somebody, what they're really thinking and feeling. No matter how hard you try, you'll never be totally sure, never truly know. You'll always be strangers. Depressing thought number 262. You will never join that gym. You will never have a six-pack. You will always feel a vague sense of self-loathing every time you undress. Number 263. You will never be as young as you are right now. See that moment that went by? That was it. It's gone. And now you're older. You can never go back. Number 264. Everyone you know will die. Sometimes suddenly, sometimes not. Sometimes they just slip away. And sometimes go out in a blaze of glory. There will come a day when you see them for the last time. Probably won't know it. No warning, no big fanfare. Just one day they'll be there and the next. Gone.
Right in front of me. Another inch, that could have been me. Bang. Dead.
Did you never learn your green cross code? Always look both ways.
It was heading on in here as well. That's lost revenue.
It's a person we're talking about here, Lily, not some fucking number on a spreadsheet.
Eddie McGuinness, 35, likes girls in PVC and stockings. Have you anything to add to that?
No.
Well, hush up and drink your tea then.
Deep breaths.
It's just... It makes you think, doesn't it? How fleeting life is. You've got to make the most of it.
I suppose.
Which is why I've got something to ask you. Is there any chance of another cup of tea?
I thought for a minute I was the other woman then.
You're just another gullible tart he'll barely remember when he wakes up. Only difference between you and Kleenex is he probably had to buy you a drink first. You can see yourself out.
are my sunshine.
And you what?
No, not you. Slut!
Oh, so I'm not your sunshine, I'm just your slut.
Shit, sorry, no, I'm just a bit all over the place. I saw it, you know, Milkman versus Postman. Fucking terrible, shut me up, it did. I had my chance and I blew it like a twat.
He's up to summit.
Who?
Marty. He's got that look. That matchy smoke and flame one.
Nice. Way past that, isn't he?
He's in the toilet.
Fucking hell, Karen. Maybe he's having a piss. Let's dial 999, shall we?
Or maybe he's planning his own personal bonfire night. So unless you want this place burning down again, get your ass into the gents.
Kelly, you are my sunshine. My starlight. My world. Will you do me the great honour of being my...
Marty, everything all right in there, mate? Marty!
I've lost it! I've lost it, Jamie, I've lost it!
Miss you. Can't stop thinking about you. Wish you were here. Love you so much. I mean, come on. Pay 60 quid a pop. Always comes on me tits and me face. And he thinks that that's love.
That's nice, dear. Yeah.
Then the dickhead only gets me name tattooed on his arm. Sherry. Sherry! It's not even my real name, stupid twat.
Hello? Girls?
Of Eddie, that poor poster.
I'm just a fucking dog, love. Now hurry up and open that letter. Come on, darling.
Come on, romance to me. Not when half of A&E are sniggering at you.
I've had one of my visions.
What?
Spirit world talking to me. A message from the other side. A warning. Like glass it will break, a bond it will take. She will shed not a tear, for a storm it draws near.
Is that JLS? Lil, where are you going?
I need to spread the word before disaster strikes. Also, we're out of batteries for the dildos.
When I woke up, I just knew today was the day. And then I saw the postman get splattered. It was like a sign.
Yeah, a sign we're getting a new postie. So what does flushing the ring down the lavvy mean?
It means I'm a fucking loser.
Might still be in there, mate. Toilets are all backed up. I'm meaning to get a plumber to sort it.
I've got short arms.
No way.
Please! I love it, Jamie. Feeny and cunt. I just wanted it to be perfect. Like she is, but no, I'm going to be alone. Because I've got stupid fucking short arms. Stupid
bastard, short ass fucking arms!
Marty.
Just give me a minute, yeah?
Yeah.
So?
Don't ask.
Jamie?
Seriously, don't ask.
Amongst men. I'd shake your hands, but...
This never happened.
Got the ring back. It's another sign. It means everything's gonna work, everything's gonna be okay.
So is Joe okay or not?
Listen, I'm willing to have a look at it, but I don't want any more of that American light piss, all right?
That's a yes, then.
I'd have more success shifting me on your end.
Oh, here comes the dirty
Fine. Yeah, we'll talk about it later, yeah? Fucking Rory. Still trying to pass off that weak shit to us.
I could go if you want.
No, it's all right, babe. No sweat.
It's a great man you got there, Karen. One of the good ones. Love. Fucking love. It's just amazing, isn't it? It's fucking amazing.
I've got something I need to ask you about Kelly. I want to propose to her.
And you've come here to ask my permission? Well, it's not up to me who that title's up with.
But you were married to her before.
If she wants to choose a little creepy pyro over me, it's her choice, isn't it?
That's all in the past.
Well, what is the past, Marty? You see, some schools of thought think that it doesn't exist. Everything happens concurrently. So while we're studying, chatting, there's another Marty, watching his wife and kids burn to death. Sorry.
Fuck off!
No, that was way below the belt.
Is that really what people think? That I killed Sue and the kids? Because it wasn't like that. I wasn't even there.
Nobody thinks you did it. I've just been a dick. You did nick my wife, after all.
Should just get a taxi stand outside the house for all the gullible girls he brings back home every night. Better than having to do the walk of shame down Chatsworth.
I need a favour.
Does it involve cash?
No.
Then? I'm listening.
I need you to cover for me at the Jockey.
Yeah, of course.
Can you be there before 2 o'clock?
Why, what's happening at 2 o'clock?
I don't know. But Jamie does, and I'm going to find out.
Sorry, I'm not following you.
He's got this text from the brewery. It's got kiss, kiss, kiss at the end.
Well, that's nothing.
I've been getting these feelings, and they just keep building and building.
It's probably some dolly bird who works for the brewery and who just texts like that. Look at me. Look at me. Jamie loves you. Stop doing this to yourself.
Morning.
Huh?
It breeds, it walks, but is it human?
Barely.
Two types of men in this world. Men like my dearest brother. And then there's the rare ones. Like your Jamie. The ones who are worthy.
Spectator sport.
I think I maybe need your help. My spiritual guidance, that sort of thing.
God have mercy on your soul. Excuse me. Mirrors?
Nah, I haven't broken any.
Now, Yeshua, the prophecy was quite specific.
Well, it's a prophecy now, because before it was just a message.
Those of us who have the gift are often mocked and shunned.
Look. Just if I was going to spend the effort sending a message to the other side, I'd make it coherent, straightforward, not a shitty poem.
20 menthol, Ches.
You see? That's a message. No mistaking it. 20 menthol. None of this for a storm draws near bollocks.
You had another one of your visions.
A dog brummit.
Didn't you also predict that the world would end in 2009?
A cat told me that one. You can't trust them cats.
Afternoon. Oh, congratulations, by the way.
Marty,
You're not over that yet?
Oh, yeah. I'm in the, Oh, bollocks.
Jane?
I said nothing, right?
Right, I'm off to see the brewery rep.
I'll see if you can get us a bit of discount then.
Oh, yeah, I'll try and get Pigs to fly and Hilderfree's over too.
Is it a man or a woman?
Who, the rep? It's a bloke, why?
Nothing, question, that's all.
Come along if you want, should be gripping stuff.
Nah, you're all right.
Okay.
I've got the ring and I've got the speech, but then I see it, I bottle it. You're a priest. You must have married loads of people.
Oh, I see. So you're asking me if I think that you and Kelly are right for each other? No. I mean, you can't make her happy, Marty. Chances are she'll turn you down or she'll run off before the wedding happens. Or a month or two down the line, you'll go home to an empty house and you'll see a lipstick message on the mirror. Goodbye, that's all she wrote.
I thought priests were meant to make people feel better about themselves.
But look at you, Marty, right, and look at her. Imagine the things that she's done to make her money. And then she's held in her arms, kissed, fucked, sucked. And ask yourself why, you know, why and all that's holy would she choose you? Out of all them men, why would she choose little twitching, stuttering Marty Fisher?
Fucking twat!
Marty, hey!
Good lad.
What?
You don't give a shit what anyone thinks, right? Not me, not your family, not your friends. It's not about us, it's about you. And, that's all. And do you love her? And does she love you? And that's it. You ask her. Ask her to marry her. And buy me another drink. Actually, do that first, you know, priorities.
Will you do our wedding?
I'll make it a double whiskey and I'll throw in some tap dancing as well.
What's wrong with you today?
Sorry, can I get a big whiskey, please?
You alone?
I've got to be more careful.
Yeah, we will be. Look, you know the rules, and I get it. It's not easy for you sometimes.
Sorry?
It's just I've got the wife and kid, and you're sort of stuck here alone, aren't you?
What? Are you feeling sorry for me?
No, I didn't mean it like that. I mean, I understand you.
He's such a great guy. Have you broken any mirrors? What? Look, I'm busy. Middle of a complex pair. Say, I've had this vision, and I'm asking everybody, it's important. Well, I've had this vision too, Lillian. Your nose is bleeding, and my knuckles are sore. You want to find out how it happens? I'm only trying to save some souls. Bye.
My sunshine, my starlight, my world. What do you think? Is sunshine better first, or starlight?
Any woman who won't marry you because you put one in front of the other isn't worth marrying, Marty.
I just want it to be right.
Well, how's your chance?
Shit, I can't do it, not here, not now. Kelly, how are you?
Something you want to tell me?
No, don't think so.
You sure?
Do you want the drink?
How about, do you want to marry me? Yeah, I know about it. I also know you've been avoiding me all day. That's right, ninja boy. I saw you hiding. So what is it? Cold feet? I think I'm not good enough for you?
No, fuck no! Just... I wanted everything to be hearts and flowers and... perfect moment, just for you.
It's life, Marty. There's no such thing as a perfect moment. Go on, then.
Here now.
You cannibal. You are my son. What?
Yes.
Mimi, I can tell you what, that woman.
You're about to do it again, aren't you?
What?
You know, start talking about me, ma'am. Tell me how fantastic in bed she is. Let me save you some time, eh?
Ah! He's in love. And love's the most important thing in the world.
There's only one thing I want to know.
I promise you, I'll love her, cherish her, honour her.
No. Are we going to have a party tonight or not?
The party! Yeah!
Oh, she said yes, then.
I want your best champagne and banners, streamers, the works. Nothing's too good for my girl.
Don't know about the streamers and banners, but we can stick up the Christmas decorations if you like.
Brilliant! Everyone loves Christmas.
Better change into me party dress then. You're back early.
Yeah, I got halfway there and the twat phones to say he couldn't make it today. Cheers for that.
You right? Yeah? Never better?
Wait, Cal!
It's all right, I meant it. I'm going to change, I'm not running out on you.
No, it's about the ring. It was my grandmother's. But it was Sue's as well. And she chucked it at me when we split up. And I kept it because I wanted to give it to someone who truly deserved it. See, my nan and granddad, they were together till they died.
You're telling me you've used this ring before? Proposal, marriage, the whole thing.
Buy you a different one. If you give me the time to get the money together, I'll get you the biggest, brightest diamond I can afford.
It's romantic.
What?
You want me to have this for the right reasons. I get it. It's romantic.
I know.
It's like Beauty and the Beast. The Beast had a thing for touching houses and shouting, wanker!
They just seem a bit wrong for each other, don't they? I like me, you, babe.
She's had more cocks than Bernard Matthews. Good luck to him.
Oh, for fuck's sake. Can't you just be happy for him?
Oh, don't you dare fall on me.
I'll do my best.
Do you think I'm fucking stupid?
What?
Sir, you think I'm fucking stupid?
What the fuck is putting into you?
You getting into my fucking husband.
Me and Jamie. Are you crazy?
I don't know. Something isn't right and it's driving me mad. And I don't know what is worse. If it's true,
or if it's all in your head. Okay. So one way or another, we will find out.
Well, someone must have broken a mirror.
And as I've told you before, it's none of us.
But my vision.
Overactive imagination.
I have the gift.
Well, you should take it back to the shop then.
Respect for your elders and betters. The boy's right. I'd hang on to the receipt if I were you. Damaged goods.
You're not gonna fuck this one up, girl. You're not gonna fuck it up, right?
Princess Kate in the house.
You look very passable, dear.
Thank you.
More importantly, this party of yours tonight. I am right in understanding there will be free beverages available.
Only because I want all the drinking, drugs, fucking and fighting out of the way tonight. I am having a proper wedding. I don't want anybody wiping blood and vomit off the pews.
And getting married in a church? Oh, well, they do say the Lord is very forgiving, even of the blackest of sheep. Now, Bin.
What's happened to these?
Vernon Francis Gallagher happened. Everyone, Bill, comes through the door now. Says he's fighting the system.
Look, this isn't a bill. It's for your matter.
You can't do that.
Oh, yeah. That little sponger gets his post sent here. It's fair game.
What?
This is from one of Marty's kids.
Get Jamie alone and then make a move on him. It's not rocket science. Look, I would do this, okay, but I am related and I think it would just creep him out.
Karen, I thought we sorted this out.
It's just this little voice in my head yapping away.
Okay, agree.
And tell her to fuck off.
Please. I need to be sure.
Marriage isn't easy. It's about compromise. It's about trust. It's about suppressing things, knowing you can't always be right, even when you are. People say it's a roller coaster, but it's more of a ghost train.
But it's good, right? I mean, you wouldn't change it for the world.
Welcome to the club.
There you go, love.
Thank you. All right?
Karen knows.
What?
Well, she suspects. Something. She sent me in here to test you.
You're kidding me?
No, Jamie.
Right, so you go back out there, you tell her what a good boy I am, and it's business as usual, yeah?
Well, how do you think this makes me feel?
Hey, like I told you before, I understand. It's not easy for you. So we'll be more careful in future. Right? Now go on.
So you've got nothing to worry about. Like I said, you've got a good man there. He just says his kid's been looking for him. I mean, most of it's all burnt, but there's an address in Spain. It just doesn't make sense.
You have to show him the letter.
But what if it means his wife, his kids, they're all still alive?
Marty would still want to be with you, no matter what. What?
Unless, of course, what?
It just seems strange. He said they were all dead, his wife's two little children. I'm sure that's what he believed. At least I hope it is. Because if he lied about this, then God knows what other dirty secrets he has tucked away. But I'm sure it's all an honest mistake. It happens all the time. Where are your wife and kids, Jim? They're dead. Oh, wait, no, they're not. They're in Sainsbury's doing the shopping.
And there'll be someone out there for you too.
Of course, there's someone out there for it. There's a fucking busload if she wants it. Traffic jams up and down the M60, tits and arse like that.
No, I just meant the one.
That's such bollocks. There's no such thing as the one.
I'll go sucker fisherman's friend.
Well, I think it's very sweet, because the view from here is usually a sea of glum and tormented faces, so it is very nice to see a smile.
Wedding's off.
Come on. Tell them what's going on, what's happening?
You fucking kid, Marty. You lied. Sympathy, was it? Oh, they died in that fire, poor fucking Marty. Don't you fucking touch me. Don't fucking look at me. Don't ever fucking talk to me again.
Come here.
like me?
Lillian here. She's out on a mission. You know, the gift.
Well, it doesn't matter. I'm back. Next customer's mine, all right?
There's a rota.
Well, fuck the rota.
You can't just come and steal punters off the rest of us.
I'm fucking working, so get the fuck out of my way.
Sorry, girl. Just business.
Marty. Hello? He's gone.
Miles away.
Maybe the lad just needs some spiritual guidance. I learnt this one in the seminary. It's a short, sharp shock.
Oh! Jesus. Stakes me fucking tits!
And we're back. Was it sent?
Last month from Spain. Got a return address and everything. What to do?
Well, most folk will tell you the right thing to do is to jump on the next plane and head over there, but there's no way of knowing. I mean, that letter could have been to tell you that to stay the hell away no matter what. Not like the good book offers much help, but even the big man upstairs more or less abandoned his kid, at least until the Roman started hammering nails into his hands and feet. This idea that we're supposed to be there for our kids, you know, that we need it, even nature thinks it's a load of bollocks. The number of animals who quite happily kick their brood out to fend for themselves. But at the end of the day, you've got to ask yourself one question. Are you doing more damage than good? Come on. Casting out pearls here, if you're going to switch off, then that's fine, but let me know, I'm not a bloody jukebox.
Everything's out of my control. I want it to burn. This place. Let's take you, everyone. Needs to be stopped. If I had $1 million or 10.
$250. Hey. Don't look now, but I think Gloria just made a move on me in the back room.
Really?
I mean, I know she's your mate and all that, but
I'll have a word with her.
Just don't go too hard on her, eh? She seems a bit lonely.
What? I said nice one. On the engagement. Yeah, put it there, mate.
Headache, eh? All that excitement.
No, I meant... It's all right if I use your toilet?
Normally, no. But seeing as today's your special day... Go on. Yeah. Just don't leave a mess.
You don't know what it's like up here. Fucking grind. Day after day, it's never ending. I actually envy you. Is that bad?
It's not bad. Fucking stupid, though.
Recommended dose 2. You recommended dose.
Oh, no. Oh, fuck, no! Oh, the fuck?
Thank you.
So, you come to bloat then?
Nah, not my style, to be honest.
Totally my style.
Don't fuck this up.
He lied to me.
He worships you. I saw his face, Cal, when you brought the news. Poor bastard didn't have a clue. He thought they were dead too, you know.
Why are you sticking up for him?
Because I love you.
We can try again.
You don't want that. You want to get fucked up and ruin everything. Like you always do. But it's changed, you know. But there's a Marty.
I have.
And bollocks.
No, I have.
Tell you what, fuck it. Let's do it. Right here, next to the old memorial tree. That'll show everyone, won't it?
All right. You've made your point.
Good. I won't say no to an hand job, though. One in a million, young man. One in a million.
Hey, are you okay? I was just gonna take all the paracetamol at once. Overdose, just finish it here and now, but I dropped them down the toilet. Clumsy twat, butter fingers.
Wait, I was gonna walk in on your body. Selfish twat, more like.
You know why I used to burn things? Because I wanted some measure of control, you know, to be responsible. But I was wrong because the world is chaotic and unpredictable and stupid. And that's why it's beautiful.
All right.
And when I saw the poster get hit by the milk van, I thought it was a sign. Not for me to move things forward, to make the most of time, but it wasn't. It was a sign to embrace the chaos.
Look, mate, I'm pretty sure it was an evil. Just one poor bastard getting hit by another poor bastard.
You know what? You're probably right.
Marty, you still owe us for the paracetamol. Wait, fuck it. Wedding present. On the house.
Listen, Marty.
Give me your hand. I am not letting you get away from me. I love you, Kelly. And you love me.
And that's why your bag's packed. That's why you're going. Right?
My son could still be alive. I have to find out what happened.
Wrong finger.
What?
Engagement ring. You put it on my right finger. Right is wrong.
Bollocks.
And we've got the engagement party.
I'll be back.
Just wait one more day. I don't want you to go, Marty. I was so scared. Scared of being hurt by you. But I want it. To be hurt, to be happy, to be...
To be everything with you. I'll be back, you know that, right? It's a promise. I'll be back.
Listen, little early for Halloween.
I'm taking you to your engagement party.
Yeah, that's not going to happen. If you think I'm going in there alone.
That is what your self-pity sounds like to me. Honest to God. That boy Marty loves you, and you love him. And everyone round here knows he will shift heaven and earth to come back to you. And if that is not a cause for celebration, I don't know what is.
Don't let me get too drunk, eh?
Christ, the thought of missing a free bar.
I don't understand. I've got the gift. I got the warning. But poor Kelly and Marty still got heartbroken.
It weren't for them, you daft cow. It was for the other couple. You were meant to save them.
What, the black ones?
The good-looking fellow and his wife.
No, Frank and Patty aren't a couple. They just share a house. You silly dog.
You stupid cow.
See you next year, love.
Depressing thought number 265. You might wait all your life for that special person, but even if you do manage to find them, they might be waiting for someone else. 266. Good times don't last forever. Friends don't stick around. At the end of the day, you're in this alone.
It's over.
Don't worry, I told you. We just need to be more careful, that's all.
No, Jamie. It's over. I thought I was hating what I'd become, but no. It's like they say, it's not me, it's you.
You've been betrayed. Knife in the back from those you thought you could trust. Depressing thought number 267. Everything you know is wrong. But you know what? Fuck 'em. Fuck all those bad thoughts. Because this is happy thought number one. I will be back.
Okay, let's get the boundaries set once and for all. Things you can and cannot say about my mum.
She's got a nice smile.
Seriously, a smile?
She's got nice eyes.
My freaking egg! It's like I can't say anything.
Good. Now we're clear.
You're not going with me?
It's your face. I couldn't help it.
Leave me alone!